Good morning, dear students. In the last session, we have learned some of the reactions of aldehydes, ketones. Now, today we are going to learn some of the reactions of aldehydes and ketones. So let us see how the aldehydes and ketones are distinguished. So by using mild oxidizing agents like Tollens reagent and Tollens reagent and Fehling test, we can distinguish aldehydes and ketones. So what is Tollens test? Ammonical silver nitrate solution is called as Tollens reagent. So when this Tollens reagent is warmed with aldehyde, it forms a carboxylate ion and a silver metal is obtained. That is, Ag plus is converted to Ag. You can see here a silver mirror is obtained. When it is obtained, when the Tollens reagent, that is ammonical silver nitrate solution, is warmed with aldehyde, you get a carboxylate ion and the silver metal. So this Tollens test is only seen by the aldehydes and not by the ketones. So aldehydes gives you the Tollens test. So what do you mean by Tollens test? Using Tollens reagent, that is ammonical silver nitrate solution, is warmed with aldehyde, it forms a silver mirror and it is not shown by the ketones. Now coming to the next test, that is Fehling test. So in Fehling test, you can see two solutions, that is solution A and Fehling solution A and Fehling solution B. In Fehling solution A, the copper sulfate, that is blue vitriol, is dissolved in water. And Fehling solution B, that it contains Rochere salt, that is sodium potassium tartrate solution. These solution A and solution B are mixed in equal quantities and it is made to react with aldehyde. So what are the two solutions of Fehling's test? Fehling's reagent contains two solutions, that is Fehling solution A and Fehling solution B. In Fehling solution, we take the small amount of copper sulfate, that is the copper sulfate solution is treated as Fehling solution A and sodium potassium tartrate is taken in Fehling solution B. These two solutions are mixed in equal quantities. So on heating with aldehydes, you get reddish brown precipitate. So the formation of reddish brown precipitate shows that aldehydes are present. So you can see here in the reaction. So this is an aldehyde. This is a failing solution. In failing solution, copper is present as Cu2+. This Cu2+ cupric ion is changing to cuprous ion. Aldehyde is treated with failing solution. It forms a red precipitate. So this failing test is also given by aldehydes but not ketones. So why it is given by aldehydes but not ketones? In aldehydes, due to the presence of this hydrogen, it gives Tollens test and as well as failing test. But whereas in ketones, you could not see the carbonyl hydrogen. So due to the presence of carbonyl hydrogen, the aldehydes shows Tollens test and as well as failing test. So what do you mean by Tollens test? Ammonical silver nitrate solution is called as a Tollens reagent. When it is warmed with aldehyde, you get a silver metal in the form of mirror. So this is called a silver mirror test. And coming to Failing's test, in Failing's solution, you can see two solutions, solution A and solution B. In solution A, copper sulfate solution is taken, and solution B, sodium potassium tartrate is seen. These are taken in equal proportion, and it is react with aldehyde. You find a red color PPT, that is the conversion of Cu2+. There in Tollens test, Ag+ is converted to Ag, and here the Cu2+ is converted to Cu. Cuprous oxide is formed. That is red color PPT is seen in Failing's test. Now coming to next one, that is oxidation of methyl ketone using haloform reaction. Generally, haloform iodoform reaction is done, which is LO precipitate is formed. Now let us see here. This reaction is observed by the only aldehyde that undergoes haloform reaction is acetaldehyde. Only acetaldehyde is shown the haloform reaction, and remaining aldehydes do not show this reaction. So you can distinguish that aldehydes with the ketones. So only methyl ketones. So what do you mean by methyl ketones? The ketones are the aldehydes which contain at least one methyl group. So this is the methyl group. It at least one methyl group it should have. Then only this reaction takes place. So the methyl group present is made to react with sodium hypohalide. That is when sodium hydroxide. How this is formed? When sodium hydroxide is reacted with halogen, you get sodium hypohalide. This sodium hypohalide forms sodium salts of carboxylic acid. And you can see here, this sodium salt contains one carbon less than its aldehyde or ketone. You can see here you have two carbons, but here you can see only one carbon. So in this test, you can see that one carbon is less than its corresponding ketone. So what is mean by oxidation of methyl ketones using haloform reaction? Here, only this reaction is seen by only acetaldehyde and by all the ketones. So it should have at least one methyl group. So when the methyl group is treated with, is oxidized with sodium hypohalite, it forms a sodium salt of corresponding carboxylic acid. And the carbon atom is having one atom less than that of carbonyl compound. and the methyl group is converted to halophone. If you take here NaOI, you get here CHI3. Similarly, you can see one more compound. Here we are taking NaOCl. The methyl group here is this one. It is substituted by ONO and the methyl group is converted to halophone, that is CHCl3. If you take iodoform, you get an LOPPT. So these are the three reactions. How do we distinguish aldehydes and ketones? The first one is Tollens test. Second one is Fehling's test. And the third one is the oxidation of methyl ketone using haloform reaction. Now, let us go with the next one, that is the reactions due to alpha hydrogen. So you have to know what do you mean by an alpha hydrogen. So alpha hydrogens, so before going to that, let us see what do you mean by alpha carbon. For example, this is a carbon, this is a functional group, carbonyl group. The carbon next to the functional group is called as alpha carbon. So this is also said to be what? Alpha carbon. So, and this is said to be what? Beta carbon. The carbons next to the functional group are called as alpha carbons and beta carbons. So the hydrogens attached to the alpha carbon are called as alpha hydrogens. So what are alpha hydrogens? So the compound, the carbon which are next to the functional group are called as alpha carbons, and the carbons and the hydrogens attached to it are called as alpha hydrogens. So here, the acidity of alpha hydrogen in aldehydes and ketones. So this acidity is due to the presence of electron withdrawing effect of the carbonyl carbon. This is stabilized by the strong conjugate base. So see here, you can see a base. Then you can see there are the two resonating structures. For example, here the oxygen is more electronegative. It has two lone pair of electrons. The pi bond shift towards oxygen, and the oxygen gets a small negative charge, and the negative charge of this oxygen move towards here. So you can see two resonating structures. Overall, you can see these two resonating structures. So due to the presence of electron withdrawing effect of the carbonyl carbon and the resonance stabilization of conjugate base. So now let us see the reactions involved with alpha hydrogen. So the first one is aldol condensation. So let us see what do you mean by aldol condensation. So generally, what do you mean by condensation reactions? The reactions where the two simple molecules combine to form a large molecule. So a general definition of condensation is two simple molecules combine to form a large molecule by the elimination of water molecule is called as condensation reaction. So what do you mean by condensation reaction? Two simple molecules. Two simple molecules combine to form a large molecule by the elimination of water molecule is called as condensation. Now let us see what do you mean by aldol condensation reactions. So here aldehydes having alpha hydrogen undergo self-condensation. Here you can see two alpha hydrogens are present. This is an alpha hydrogen, and this is also an alpha hydrogen. So alpha hydrogen undergoes self condensation when you warm with dilute acid or a base. We have taken two acetaldehydes. When it is treated with a mild base, you will get an alpha beta product. That is, see here why it is called as an aldol, because it contains aldehyde group and as well as hydroxy group. So that's why the name for aldol is the same molecule contains aldehyde group and hydroxyl group. So that's why the name is given as aldol. So aldol and ketones, they readily loses water molecule and forms alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound. So you know, so the two acetaldehyde molecules, two similar aldehyde molecules, when they are reacting in presence of a base, they form an aldol product. You can see this is an aldehyde group and this is an hydroxyl group. So when you number it, this is the first carbon, second carbon, and third carbon. So this is an alpha carbon and this is beta carbon. So you name it as 3-hydroxy. So this is the third carbon. So 3-hydroxy butanol. So water molecule and form butene. Butene all alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound. So the OH group from here and hydrogen from this are eliminated as water, and you get an alpha beta unsaturated compound. So here you can see a double bond. By the removal of OH and H, you get a double bond here. That is alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound. So this reaction is said to be aldol condensation. That is, the aldehydes and ketones should have at least one alpha hydrogen undergo reaction in presence of dilute alkali as a catalyst to form beta hydroxy aldehyde. This is said to be what, beta hydroxy aldehyde. Are beta hydroxy ketones. If we take here acetone, you get beta hydroxy ketone. This reaction is said to be aldehyde aldol condensation. So even though this reaction is seen by ketones, it is said to be ketol condensation. But preferably we call ketol condensation also as an aldol condensation. So here in aldol and ketol condensation, we have taken two similar aldehydes or two similar ketones. But coming to next cross aldol condensation. Here in cross aldol condensation, we generally take two different aldehydes or two different ketones. Two different aldehydes and two different ketones, or you can also take one aldehyde and one ketone. So here we have taken benzaldehyde. In cross aldol condensation, it is similar to that of aldol condensation. But in aldol condensation, we take similar aldehydes or ketones. But in cross aldol condensation, either we take two different aldehydes or two different ketones, or an aldehyde and a ketone. So here in aldehyde, so in this reaction, we have taken benzaldehyde and acetophenone. In presence of a base NaOH, it forms an hydroxy compound, beta hydroxy compound, by the removal of water molecule. This OH and this H, it forms as a water molecule and forms, see here you can see this is the first carbon, second carbon, and third carbon. First carbon, second carbon, and third carbon. So the root word is prope. So the root word is prope. And here on the second carbon, you can see a double bond. So it is propene. And you can see phenyl groups on the first carbon and the third carbon. So you name it as 1,3-diphenyl, 1,3-diphenyl propene 2,1-one. Propene 2,1-one. So what is the name of this product? 1,3-diphenyl propene 2,1-one. So this is said to be what? Cross aldol condensation. Now let us see what do you mean by Cannizzaro reaction. So in aldol condensation we have seen reaction with alpha hydrogen, but in Cannizzaro reaction the aldehydes which do not have an alpha hydrogen atom. So you can see here the formaldehyde do not have an alpha hydrogen. Here this is an alpha hydrogen. Formaldehyde do not have an alpha hydrogen. So this reactions are said to be Cannizzaro reaction. So in benzaldehyde also you cannot see. So in Cannizzaro reaction also, in Cannizzaro reaction, you can see the aldehydes which do not have alpha hydrogen. The aldehydes are ketones which do not have alpha hydrogen undergo Cannizzaro reaction. So here they undergo self-oxidation. The same molecule undergo oxidation and as well as reduction. That is said to be what is proportionation. So if the same molecules undergo oxidation and reduction, then it is said to be disproportion reaction. So it is done when the formaldehyde is reacted with concentrated alkali, it forms the salt of carboxylic acid, that is sodium. In presence of sodium hydroxide, you get sodium formate and methanol. So here the formaldehyde undergo disproportionation. One molecule will form into the salt of carboxylic acid and the other will form into methanol. So the formaldehyde reaction, this reaction is said to be Cannizzaro reaction. So coming to benzaldehyde, so here benzaldehyde also do not have, benzaldehyde do not have alpha hydrogen. So in presence of a strong base like potassium hydroxide or sodium hydroxide, one of the molecule will form into benzenol and the other form into a salt of the benzoic acid. That is, it forms as a potassium benzoate. Here we got sodium. In presence of sodium hydroxide, we got sodium formate and here you get sodium benzoate. This reaction is called as Cannizzaro reaction. So in Cannizzaro reactions, the aldehydes are ketones which do not have alpha hydrogen atom undergo self-oxidation and reduction. This is said to be what? Disproportionation reaction. On heating with concentrated alkali, either sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide, you get the sodium salt of carboxylic acid and an alcohol is formed. Here the alcohol is formed and here the salt is formed. Now coming to the next topic of this chapter, that is carboxylic acid. So what is carboxylic acid? So the compound, the organic compounds which contains
carboxyl group is called as carboxylic acid. So here you can see in carboxylic group, you can see the carbonyl group and as well as the hydroxyl group. When a carbonyl group is attached to the hydroxyl group, then you get carboxylic acid. So what's the formula of carboxylic acid? COOH. So the carbonyl group is attached to the hydroxyl group is called as carboxylic acid. So the carboxylic acids are again of two types. They are aliphatic carboxylic acids and aromatic carboxylic acids. So what do you mean by aliphatic carboxylic acids? When the carboxylic acids are attached to the aliphatic carbon alkyl group, when the COOH group is attached to alkyl group, then it is said to be aliphatic carboxylic acid. And similarly, when the carboxyl group, functional group is attached to an aromatic like benzene, then it is said to be the aromatic carboxylic acids. So the higher members of aliphatic carboxylic acids are known as fatty acids. So the fatty acids occur in natural fat as esters of glycerol. So what are carboxylic acids? The acids are the compounds which contains COOH group, that is carboxyl functional group, are called as carboxylic acids. Here it contains a carbonyl group and an hydroxyl group. It's of two types. There are aliphatic carboxylic acids and aromatic carboxylic acids. If the carboxyl group is attached to alkyl carbon, then it is said to be aliphatic carboxylic acids. And if it is attached to an aromatic ring, then it is said to be aromatic carboxylic acids. Let us see the nomenclature and structure of the carboxylic acid. So you know that the carboxylic acids are derived, most of the carboxylic acids are known by their common names. So how the names are derived? Simply by replacing. By replacing E with oic acid. So if it is methane, if it is one carbon, so the ane is E is replaced by oic acid, that is methanoic acid. Here it is ethanoic acid, CH3COOH, commonly known as vinegar or acetic acid. So methanoic acid, the formula of methanoic acid is HCOOH, and commonly it is known as formic acid. It is ethanoic acid. Again, coming to this compound, how many number of carbon atoms are there? First carbon, second, two carbon, three carbon, four, five, and six. So the root word is carbon. So here total six number of carbons are there. So the root word is hexane. All the single bonds are present. So it is hexanoic. Due to the presence of this hexanoic acid. And at the fourth carbon, methyl group is present. So it is 4-methylhexanoic acid. And here you can see only two carbons are there, first carbon and second carbon. On second carbon, you can see the substituent. And the second carbon, you can see chlorine is substituted. So you write it as 2-chloroethanoic acid. Coming to this compound, you can see first carbon, second carbon, and third carbon. So the root word is, all single bonds are present. So it is propanoic, propane. And here acidic group is present. So it is propanoic acid. And on the second carbon and on third carbon, you can see chlorine atom. So it is said to be, the name of this compound is 2,3-dichloropropanoic acid. Now you can see here, benzoic acid. And let us see some of the important structures of some carboxylic acid with the common and IUPAC name. See here, HCOOH. HCOOH is commonly known as formic acid. So why it is known as formic acid? Because in Latin, red ants are known as formica. So from as that releases formic acid, so that releases acid, formic acid. So the name is given as formic acid. And only one carbon is there, so it is said to be methanoic acid. So here this CH3COOH is called as acetic acid. As it is present in vinegar, it is commonly known as acetum. Vinegar is commonly known as acetum. So as it is present in vinegar, it is called as acetic acid. And the IUPAC name of it is ethanoic acid. So the formula of formic acid is HCOOH. And it's, as it is derived from red ants, so it is said to be formic acid. And the second one is ethanoic acid, are commonly called as acetic acid. And the next one is the three number of carbon atoms there and the functional group COOH. So it is propanoic acid. And this propanoic acid is released by the propionic bacteria, which is present in the intestine and sweat glands. So they are obtained by the process of fermentation of propionic bacteria. So the next one is with four carbon atoms. So it is said to be butyric acid, butyric acid. So this is seen in butter. So that's why it is said to be butyric acid. So the next one is isobutyric acid. And the next one is, here you can see two acidic groups are present. So it is dioic acid. In the above examples, you can see only one single COOH group is present. So, but here you can see two carboxyl groups are present. So it is dioic acid. So here two carbons are there. So it is said to be ethane dioic acid. It is commonly called as oxalic acid, which is present in green leafy vegetables and as well as in tomato. Coming to the next one, see here, this is also a dioic acid, but in between two carboxyl groups, CH2 group is present. So it is propanoic acid, and it is commonly known as malonic acid. This is found in apples and grapes and broccoli. Coming to the next, all these are dioic acids. You can see maximum of the aldehydes and carboxyl groups are present at the terminal of the chain. They are present at the ends of the compound. See here, the three carbons are there, so it is propane dioic acid. Here, four carbons will be there, it is butane dioic acid. Five are there, pentane dioic acid, and if six are there, it is hexane dioic acid. It is commonly known as oxalic acid, ethane dioic acid, and this is said to be malonic acid, propane dioic acid, and this is succinic acid, which is
the IUPAC name of succinic acid is butanediuric acid. Next one, it is glutaric acid. Total 5 carbons are there. So it is pentanediuric acid. And for adipic acid, 6 carbons are there. It is 6 hexane dioic acid. Next one, this is benzoic acid. Benzene carboxylic acid commonly. We can also, this benzoic acid, it is also the same in IUPAC name also. And coming to the next one is phenyl acetate. 2 phenyl ethanoic acid, and this 2 acidic groups are there. So it is benzene 1,2 dicarboxylic. This is the benzene ring, and this is first carbon and second carbon. Benzene 1,2 dioic acid. Now coming to the structure of carboxyl group. So you know the carbon atom has 2 oxygen atoms. So this is the structure of carboxyl group. It has 3 resonating structures. So all these all the carbon bonds are present in one plane with bond angle 120. Here you can see this 2 oxygen atoms are present on carboxyl group. That is, this oxygen contains 2 lone pair of electrons, and this oxygen also contains 2 lone pair of electrons. When this pi bond shifts towards this side, this will get a negative charge and the carbon will get a positive charge. So the oxygen lone pair of electrons is given, so it will get a positive charge, a double bond, and a negative charge to the oxygen. So the oxygen, and here in carboxyl group, it contains 2 electron deficient sites. That is, in C plus is also an electron deficient site, and this O plus is also an electron deficient site. But O minus is electron rich. So if you want to do protonation, this oxygen undergoes protonation. So this carboxylic carbon is less electrophilic than carbonyl carbon because of the possible resonance structures. So due to these 3 resonance structures, it is less electrophilic than that of simple carbonyl carbon. So again, all these bonds are present in same plane and they have bond angle 120 degrees. They have 3 resonating structures. Due to the presence of this more electronegative oxygen, now let us see how do we prepare carboxylic acid. So we can prepare carboxylic acid by alkyl benzene. So this is an alkyl benzene. This is an alkyl benzene. let us see the preparation of, sorry for inconvenience, let us see the preparation of the carboxylic acids. So the carboxylic acids are prepared from alkyl benzenes. So alkyl benzenes when it is reacting with strong oxidizing agents like chromic acid or potassium permanganate, you get the sodium salt of carboxylic acid, and on hydrolysis, we get benzoic acid. So the aryl carboxylic acids are prepared by aromatic when substituted benzenes are treated with strong oxidizing agents like potassium permanganate, you get the sodium salt of carboxylic acid. On hydrolysis, you get benzoic acid. See here, you can see the longest chain. This longest chain is also oxidized to carboxyl group. This is total. The length of the carbon chain may be very big, but total this substituted chain is oxidized, and you get a carbox. You can see here the potassium salt of benzoic acid. On hydrolysis, you get benzoic acid. So when substituted benzene is oxidized in presence of strong oxidizing agents like potassium permanganate, get sodium potassium salt. On hydrolysis, you get benzoic acid. Now coming to preparation of carboxylic acids from nitriles and amides. So what are nitriles? Any organic compound attached to the CN group are said to be the nitrile. So when the nitriles are hydrolyzed to amides and then to acids in presence of the acidic medium or the basic medium or as a catalyst. When you use mild reaction, then the reaction stops at amide position only. So from nitriles also you can prepare the benzoic acid. Simply nitriles when hydrolyzed, it forms amides. On further hydrolysis in presence of acidic or basic medium, you get the corresponding acid. See here, ethanamide. On hydrolysis, you get ethanoic acid and ammonia, and benzamide on hydrolysis in presence of an acidic medium get benzoic acid. And from Grignard reagents, you know what do you mean by Grignard reagent? RMGX is called as Grignard reagent. Grignard reagents react with carbon dioxide to form salts, on which in turn forms the acid. So the Grignard reagent RMGX react with carbon dioxide to form the corresponding salt, and on further hydrolysis and acid hydrolysis, you get propion, that is acid. So you can see this is the Grignard reagent when it is reacted with carbon dioxide in presence of acidic. On hydrolysis in presence of acid medium, you get benzoic acid. From acyl halides, next reaction is from acyl halides or anhydride. From acyl halides, so acyl chloride, simply when hydrolyzed with water. You can see when acyl halides are hydrolyzed, you get a benzoic acid. That is carboxylic acid.
but more readily it is hydrolyzed in presence of a aqueous base. So simply you can hydrolyze the acid halides to form benzoic acid, but it readily forms when it is treated with the base. You get the corresponding salt, and on hydrolysis you get the respective carboxylic acid. You can see here benzoic anhydride. On hydrolysis you get benzoic acid. So simply acid chlorides are acyl chlorides on hydrolysis in presence of a base you get the salt, and further hydrolysis you get the corresponding acid. Now let us see the physical properties of carbon. Carboxylic acids are polar molecules. The formic acetic propionic acids and acids are completely soluble in water, and the carbons like compounds with 5 to 8 carbons, the carboxylic acids are partially soluble in water, and more than 8 carbons, they are insoluble in water. So due to the presence of intensive hydrogen bonding, you can see here hydrogen bondings are more here. So due to the presence of hydrogen bonding, they are having high boiling point than alcohols and corresponding esters. So you can see here two hydrogen bondings are there, and it forms as a dimer even in vapor phase. The saturated carboxylic acids having less than 10 carbon atoms are liquids, and more than that they are a waxy like solids. In water, the carboxylic acid dissociates and causes acidosis. Now coming to the reaction of carboxylic acids. So here, this is an acid. When it is reacting with the sodium, it is more acidic than alcohols, because of the presence of, it can easily release H+ ion. So you can see here, when the acid is reacting with, when the acetic acid is reacting with a metal, you get hydrogen gas. Similarly, when it is reacting with when it is reacting with the sodium metal, you are getting, it liberates hydrogen gas. When it is reacting with sodium hydroxide, it is producing water. Similarly, it is reacting with sodium hydrogen carbonate and sodium carbonate to liberate carbon dioxide and water gas. See, this is the acidic character. This shows the acidic character of carboxylic acid. It reacts with metals and liberates hydrogen gas. It reacts with the base and forms water. It reacts with the milder agents like sodium hydrogen carbonate and sodium carbonate and forms carbon dioxide gas. So let us see the effect of substituents on the acidic of carboxylic acid. So you know that we don't electron donating groups. So in electron withdrawing group, it stabilizes the carboxylate anion and strengthens the acidic character. So here you can see if the electron withdrawing groups like chlorine, fluorine, bromine, iodine, CN, they increases the acidic character of the carboxylic group, because they are the electron withdrawing group. So the electron withdrawing group stabilizes the carboxylate anion and strengthens the acid. But whereas electron donating group, it destabilizes the carboxylate anion and weakens the acid. So this becomes less acidic. By the carboxylic acid becomes more acidic when with attached with electron withdrawing group and becomes less acidic when it is attached with electron donating group. See, let us see some of the chemical reactions of carboxylic acid. Formation of anhydride. So what do you mean by anhydride? This is general word which you come across in chemistry. Anhydride. Anhydride means the removal of water molecule. Anhydrous. For example, if you see H2SO4, if you remove water molecule from it, you get SO3. So you can see that anhydride. SO3 is anhydride of sulfuric acid. So anhydrous. Similarly, if you see copper sulfate 5H2O, if you remove this 5H2O, it becomes anhydrous salt. So by the elimination of water molecule, if you get a compound, then that is said to be anhydride. Similarly, here you can see the carboxylic acid. So carboxylic acid, two carboxylic acids, two molecules of ethanoic acid. This is CH3COOH and this is also CH3COOH. These loses water molecules. So OH from this and H from this, they loses water molecules and form ethanoic anhydride in presence of mineral acids such as sulfuric acid or nitric acid or phosphorus pentoxide to form anhydride, that is carboxylic acids on heating with mineral acids like sulfuric acid are in presence of phosphorus pentoxide, it forms ethanoic anhydride. So now let us see the reactions of carboxylic acids with PCl5, with PCl5, PCl3 and thionyl chloride. So here the OH group is substituted by Cl, that's all. Because here the hydroxyl group is more active when it is reacting with PCl5, PCl3 and thionyl chloride. So OH group is substituted, Cl group is substituted by OH, you can see here. So out of these three, PCl5, PCl3 and SOCl2, SOCl2 thionyl chloride is more preferable than these two, because here in when the carboxylic group is treated with thionyl chloride, you get sulfur dioxide and hydrogen chloride. These two easily escapes from the reaction and you get purely acyl chloride. So, but here there is a need for removing these two compounds. So generally it is preferred to react with, for the preparation of acyl chloride, it is better to take thionyl chloride. Now esterification, you know very well what is esterification. The reaction between the carboxylic acid and the alcohol in presence of an acid gives you the acetyl. So this is an acid in presence of an alcohol, reacts with alcohol in presence of an acid as catalyst, you get as acetyl and water. This reaction is called as esterification. And coming to reaction with ammonia, carboxylic group reacts with ammonia to give ammonium salt, which on further heating to a high temperature gives amides. So you can see amide is formed. So the carboxylic acid reacts with ammonia to give ammonium salt. On further heating at a high temperature, it forms amides. Now reactions involving COOH group reduction. So you know what do you mean by reduction? Removing of oxygen or addition of hydrogen. Here the oxygen group is removed by the addition of hydrogen. So here the carboxylic acids are reduced to primary alcohol. This is the primary alcohol. In presence of strong reducing agents like lithium aluminium hydride or with diborane, this diborane cannot be reduced. It cannot reduce esters or the diborane cannot reduce esters. And here sodium esters are nitros or halo compounds. Here the sodium borohydrate is also not used because it do not reduce. Only the best reducing agent is lithium aluminium hydride. The carboxylic acid forms primary alcohol in presence of strong oxidizing agent like lithium aluminium hydride. Now coming to decarboxylation, carboxylic acid loses carbon dioxide gas. You can see here the carbon dioxide gas is lost and forms a hydrocarbon. The carboxylic acids use carbon dioxide to form hydrocarbons in presence or when it is treated with the sodium salts like soda lime. Soda lime is a mixture of sodium hydroxide and calcium oxide in 3:1 ratio. So what do you mean by decarboxylation? The removal of the loss of carbon dioxide from carboxylic acid to form a hydrocarbon. So when it is treated with sodium hydroxide, it forms a sodium salt of carboxylic acid. Then again, it is treated with soda lime to form a hydrocarbon. Now, halogenation. So this is important. HVZ reaction. Hell-Willhardt-Zelensky reaction. Here, the alpha hydrogen is substituted. Chlorine is substituted by alpha hydrogen. Halogens are substituted by the alpha hydrogen. So the carboxylic acid having alpha hydrogen are halogenated at alpha position on treatment with chlorine or bromine in presence of small amount of red phosphorus to give alpha carbon. So this is said to be Hell-Willhardt Zelensky reaction, that is commonly HVZ reaction. Here the carboxylic acid, the alpha hydrogen is substituted by the chlorine or bromine. Now coming to ring substitution reaction, the aromatic carboxylic acids undergo electrophilic substitution reaction in which a carboxylic group acts as a deactivating and these are meta-directing group. So here the nitric the NO2 is directed towards meta direction and bromine is also directed towards meta direction. Now coming to the uses of carboxylic acid, ethanoic acid is used as a flavoring and as well as a preservative. It is used for making drugs, dyes, paints, insecticides and plastics. Ethanoic acid is used in rubber, textile, dyeing and is used as a coagulating latex. Higher fatty acids are used in making soaps and detergents. Benzoic acid is used as a preservative. So with this, the lesson is completed. Thank you all for giving this opportunity. Have a great day.